Joining us now is John Avlon, senior political columnist for Newsweek and The Daily Beast. John, good to have you with us.
Good morning.
Not to sound too tawdry, of course, but to be a fly on the wall with a conversation between Anthony and his wife this morning. What do we think? How do we think this is going to play out?
Look, nobody knows what goes on in a relationship except the two people in it, but we all know way too much about Anthony Weiner's hobbies, and this is going to be a tough conversation. His wife, thankfully, frankly, has been spared, I think, the spectacle of the last 3 weeks and the constant stream of photographs that keep coming out and somehow retain the ability to shock. But this, clearly, colleagues hope, is what he needs to take the step, not only to get the help he needs, but also resign from Congress.
How much pressure is he getting from the Democratic Party right now? I mean, from what we hear what's on the outside, but on the inside, how much pressure is he getting?
Huge amounts of pressure. Like, there's virtually nobody defending him at this point. And I think Anthony Weiner, who's a fighter, his instinct was to stay, to stay in there. He looked at the precedent of people like David Vitter, who survived a sex scandal, be reelected. His colleague from the New York delegation, Charlie Rangel, was reelected by 80% after he had a fiscal scandal. But the reality is there's no base of support left, certainly in the congressional leadership. This has been a deep distraction for Democrats for 3 weeks. The Pew Research poll found that it occupied a fifth of all news coverage last week. This isn't getting better because there are more photographs out there.
Like Nancy mentioned, it's not easy. If he chooses not to resign, it's not easy to remove him. Does it come down to the fact that, like you mentioned, he's really got no one in his corner right now? No one has come to his defense.
There is no one in his corner. I mean, all the leadership, even the President of the United States, have all said, do the right thing, you need to resign, or this will remain a distraction. The reality is, even if he tries to stick this out, his district will likely be redistricted out of existence. If he wants to keep the loyalty of his constituents, which polls shows he have, he should get help and run again in the future.
Does this something you think happens today? I mean, once the President enters the fray, then it's one thing for Nancy Pelosi, Harry Reid, for them to chime in. But now that the President has come out and said, if I were in his shoes, I would resign. Do we think today is probably the day, now that his wife is back, and like we've mentioned, he's got really no leg to stand on here.
Yeah, I mean, this clearly does come down to a family conversation with his wife. He's got a lot of amends to make, a lot of healing to do, but there is simply no one left in his corner. Everyone has come out and said he should resign. That's the right thing to do for the party, for the country, for his constituents.
If you had to make a prediction, do you think this is a quick process? Do you think it's probably, like I said, today, within the next couple of days, or is he the type of guy that might want to drag this out?
I think in the next few days. I mean, look, there's been nothing quick about this process. It's been 3 weeks, but I think we're closer to the end of this than the beginning, certainly.
Let's talk about the congressional poll, CBS poll, showed 16% approval for Congress right now. What does this do to the bigger picture? When we talk about this being a bit of an embarrassment and a black eye on Congress as a whole and the Democratic Party, I think a lot of people, one of the reasons they've stayed kind of far from coming to his defense is because this is such a black eye.
Well, look, it really compounds the crisis of trust we have in national institutions. I mean, the steady drip of scandal, especially sex scandals out of our politicians, just further erodes the faith and confidence we have in them. And as long as Anthony Weiner is a symbol of the Democratic Party, they're on defense. They can't do anything else, and they clearly want to turn the page.
Okay. John Avlon, thanks. Good to see you here
Thank
this
you.
Morning.
Good.